agent. I started off my life at Pearl Assurance, and I was on the life assurance side. And to be honest, brutally honest, I didn't really like it that much. And after about 10 months, I decided that the actuarial work that I was doing wasn't statistical enough for me. And I had more of a statistical background. That was my sort of degree. And I resigned. And I was going to go back and do a postgraduate degree in statistics and then think about a career change. And my manager at the time said to me, "Oh, Mike, you know, we don't want to lose you. I understand you're a bit frustrated, but we've got this department on the general branch. Actuaries don't actually work there," he said, "but I think you might find it interesting in their motor division." So I thought, well, I'll give it a try. I'll give it a try. I'm still resigning, but you know, hey ho, you know, see what happens. Well, I was there a day, and I relinquished my resignation, and I sensed within a day that this was a proper job, and I found myself being involved in the pricing team, and this was 1980. And then I sort of discovered that I was one of the first actuaries working in personal lines motor pricing at the time. And it was a greenfield site, you know, and technology then wasn't, you know, there wasn't PCs and they were slowly emerging, but, you know, but you could actually apply proper statistical analysis to data and frequency, severity, looking at statistical models and turning them into premium rates is what I'd done in the sort of early 80s, and I absolutely loved it. So to me, I've been in the motor insurance field ever since. That's 40 years, can you believe it? And it's still as exciting as ever. So I would recommend, you know, to be honest, if anyone gets a sniff, an opportunity to work A, in general insurance, and then B, in personal lines, you know, that will be the best career move possible.